Now we've covered how to do the back kick in detail, let's look at the problems we get. Big one is people don't look forwards, they look down. And by looking down, you tend to break at the hips and you're not keeping tension there. And this allows the feet to actually pull you upwards. So the best way you can fix this is to have a stationary object to look at. The diver you can see closest is using the top of the rock. The diver further away is using the middle of the rock. I suggest using the middle would be a better idea. You can see here that both divers are keeping good head position initially, but the diver closest, as they get further away, you can see they start to look down and no doubt the feet are now starting to rise. And especially while you're learning this kick, the key would be to keep the distance you're moving short and just repeat moving close to the rock, moving away, moving close, moving away. Doing this will help reduce your frustration levels. Once your feet do start to rise, you tend to switch off with the hips. Remember, the feet must return back to a location parallel with the body, fintips down. Here you see the diver's fintips all the time are high. Yes, we're going backwards, but that's why we're also rising. Another common problem is the diver is pulling the fin blades flat through the water. And by pulling them flat through the water, you're not gripping any water, thus making a lot of effort and not really moving backwards at all. You need to keep good tension in the fin pocket, toes pulling towards your knees, and you need to turn the fin blades and pull so the side of the blade becomes parallel with the water, not pulling flat. And remember, slow the kick down, feet stay low. As we've shown, practice on a wall is a good idea. What I'm correcting here is the heels should not be touching each other. It's very normal that a diver's thinking a lot about their legs and hips and they forget their feet position. What problem we're having here is the knees are not moving and the blade angle is also very flat. So I'm just giving some cues there about having the knees start in, move out, but the feet, instead of rising, try and keep them in line with the butt and twist that foot instead of keeping it flat to the water. During courses, I often find it useful to go behind the student. Now the fintips, if you look, you can see them at the start of the kick, but then he was starting to lose that hollow body position. So what I'm doing is pushing the fintips back down, legs together. Now as I do that, you can see he starts to wobble a little bit. And the primary reason for this is there's no tension in the hips. And if the hips aren't tensioned, the feet cannot be tensioned correctly. This causes frustration and divers to speed the kick up, which you definitely do not want to do. So what I do is get him to watch me and you'll see that I'm slowing the kick down, resetting the feet each time, turning the fin blades and I'm moving backwards. So the key is slow down and hold the tension in the hips. And now I'm showing that if you do it fast, I'm going really fast of course, your hips just rise and you don't really move back at all. So the key, slow it down. You should see the fin tips each time below the diver. Here's a view from the back, nice and slow, reset the position, and you can see the fins really bending there, and that's because I have a good blade angle. And it's not a fast kick, you should move back very slowly and smoothly, and it should be in a horizontal line. This is great to see, the diver training here, really taking the time to put the fins back into position slowly, pointing them down. He has good tensioning in the hips, good breathing control, good angle with the fin blades, looking forwards. It can be useful to have a second person in the water just to help you with the knee position and foot blade position. Having somebody else to record everything is also a very good idea, then you can review back what problems you're having. But here I'm just putting the fins down to start position. And the diver's just learning that blade angle. Now they've still got to work on holding tension in the hips. They've still got to work at breathing control, looking ahead. So many things are happening here, and you need to have good advanced buoyancy control prior to learning this kick, or you'll start learning bad muscle memory and habits, and you really want to avoid this. As one of the biggest problems I have is breaking down what people have been practicing, and they've got hundreds of dives. And just to take somebody off the street who's never dived before, honestly, I find it much easier to teach them to back kick than someone with a lot of experience practicing bad habits. The key, do not get frustrated. Only practice this when you feel ready to practice it. Go down, set yourself in the correct position, have good conditions. If you've got current and things happening, forget it, practice it another day. Make sure you can hold level and you don't rise. Keep good tension in the hips. Make sure you're turning the ankle blade and your feet are resetting. So you want to keep them lower. And as soon as you start to break at the hips or speed the kick up, honestly, stop practicing for the day and review what you did. Review these videos. And then what you want to make sure is you're doing the correct kick. Once you master this kick, it really is amazing. You will have had good buoyancy control, good body position, good underwater awareness, full control of your fin blades, and you will be able to maneuver underwater just like a helicopter can maneuver in the air. And who knows, you may even find that you can fin backwards faster than a recreational diver can fin forwards. So keep practicing and review what you practice.